say hallelujah. Let me tell y'all something right now. This is my song right here. This is right here. Now you know what? See, some of y'all, I don't know. Just James, give me some volume in this mic.
Yeah.
All this equipment. Turn it, put some volume in.
Hold on.
Put some volume in the mic. That's good.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
I
say hallelujah. Here, one more time. Tell somebody, say, I know that he will. He'll do whatever you believe in him for. God. I say hallelujah. We got through with praise and worship, but I went to the hospital yesterday. Members of LaVell Allen, man, he started bleeding from his brain.
Yeah.
He just a blood vessel bust in his brain. And he had just preached on Wednesday night, doing good, planning on going golfing on Saturday. Friday night, a blood bust in his blood, a vessel in his brain bust. So he got fluid on his brain. He tells his wife, I got a headache. They said watching TV. Nothing never happened. He tells his wife, I got a headache. She said, you want a pill? You want an aspirin or something? He said, yeah, give me a pill, because got a. And after a while, he said he felt, she told me, said he felt his own known. And so she asked and said, do you want me to take to the hospital? He said, no, you don't take to the hospital. He said, I want you to take me. Call the ambulance. She said, immediately when he said that, she knew that something was wrong.
Yeah.
Ambulance came to pick him up, took him to the hospital. Let me tell you something. You better want to praise God while you got your strength.
Yeah.
Sometimes y'all be making me so sick with y'all. I can preach like this. I'm in my old church. I don't tell other folks. But y'all making me. Sometimes you be sitting like that nigga. You better go ahead and give God some praise.
Yeah.
See, you don't know, you might feel good today. And the brother, what the heck, you're going to keep yourself up, you got to eat properly. And then all of a sudden, a blood vessel just bust in your brain. No, he wasn't in the hospital, and he ain't never had no problem with none of that. It's just that thing just happened.
Yeah. Glory.
I heard about it. We had a minister's meeting. I heard about it. Bishop called me and they told me we canceled the meeting.
Yes.
We canceled the pastoral meeting because we couldn't get nothing done. We knowing that a minister's like that. And we got up and shot over to the hospital.
Yes.
Shot over to the hospital, got there. And when I saw him, he's unconscious, bleeding from the head. They had to run a tube in his brain.
Yeah. Thank you, God.
To get the fluid off his brain.
Yeah.
This is a healthy man.
Yeah, yes.
Hallelujah.
And the doctor telling his wife that they telling his wife that this is 75% chance that he might not come out of this. They ain't coming out of this.
Amen.
They didn't know what caused it.
Bless your God.
Oh, glory.
Oh, no. And, sometimes, I know why y'all come to church. I know. And I understand the faith come by word here. I got a job to do. You got to believe God. Say not worry about your situation and your circumstances and what they say about you and what went right for you. You ought to be glad that you are alive. That's something.
Yeah.
Immediately I started talking to God right then.
Yeah.
Immediately I started talking to God right then. Because I know if it happened to him, it can happen to me.
Yeah.
I started catching that stuff up. I said, well, that ain't happening to me, Father. I said, oh God, in the name of Jesus, that's amen. I said, every blood vessel get right. Every vein get right. But come on, sometimes the enemy will slip up on you. That the life is in the power of what you say. Tell your neighbor, you better speak into your atmosphere. Keep devils out.
Hallelujah.
Keep sickness out. keep circumstances away. Tell somebody, say, you better start talking. Sit there and acting like you cute if you wanna. You better not let the devil call you to shut your mouth. That the life is in the power of what you say. Bishop can lay hands on you, Bishop can pray for you, but if you ain't opening up your mouth, come on, declare some stuff. My body is well. My children are here. My house is blessed. I'll never be the same again. Even though I'm going through something, I'm coming out. I'm going to be all that God wants me to be. Come on, you got to say, I'm going to be all that God wants me to be. Come on, tell somebody, I'm going to be all that God wants me to be. Everything God wants me to be, I'm going to be it. I'm going to be it.
Hallelujah! Hallelujah!
Come on, give God some praise in here. God, destiny is set before us. And the enemy ain't feeling sorry for you. You better start feeling sorry for yourself. You better start opening up your mouth and say, devil, you better get your hands off my life. Touch your neighbor, somebody release a praise right here. Yeah, I'm about to, I don't feel like it, but I'm about to give God a real good praise. And this praise ain't about no feeling. This praise ain't about how I think. This praise ain't not about my imperfection. This praise right now, I'm going to glory. Come on, give God some praises, y'all. Oh, God. Oh, God. God, I feel a breakthrough in here. My God, y'all. I feel a breakthrough in here. I feel a miracle. I feel it. My God. Open your mouth and declare destiny. Tell the devil, my house gonna be prosperous. My house is gonna be well. I can do all things through Christ that strengthened me. My God. Because if the enemy could have killed you, he'd have killed you a long time ago. God got too much stuff for you. Come on, give him a praise. Give him a praise. Give him a praise. He'll fight my battle. Hallelujah. I tell him I hold my peace. He'll fight my battle. I say hallelujah. My God, I done got all out of order. I done got out of order. But it's pastoral Sunday, so don't y'all look for me to do it. Give me some hallelujah. It's past, I done got all out of order. Holy Ghost, take over. Tell your neighbor, say, the Holy Ghost gonna take over now. You ain't got to worry about it no more. You can look cute long as you want. Hey, if you need whatever you need right now, this is time. The water is stirring right now. The water. You better dip in the thing right now. How much you gonna get in the hole? You gotta dip right there. Sometimes all you wait on is a swimming on the water. I come to tell you something right now. Hallelujah, hallelujah. 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 We bless your name, Lord God. Hallelujah. Woo! Hallelujah. I said hallelujah. Hey, hey, if you can believe God, all things are possible. Let me say it again. I said, if you can believe God, all things are possible. Turn to your neighbors. I ain't got time for the haters. I ain't got time for no dollars. Say, I'm gonna believe God for this thing. I know it look like it ain't gonna come to pass. I know the doctor done told me something different. But if you can believe God, all things are possible. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah. Okay. All right.
Yes, sir.
All right. I know I came to long this service, but can you say hallelujah? Hallelujah. All right, I'm going to do this little part right here, and then I'm going to sit down, and I'm going to get back into all of our service. Let me tell you something, what's happening. Let me tell you the season. Let me tell you the season you're living in now. You listening at me?
Yes. Yes, 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 Lord. Hallelujah.
Let me tell you the season that you're living in. You're living in the season now where God want to really finish what he started in your life. Some things that was unsettled, God said, I'm ready to settle up.
Thank you, God.
That's the season you're living in. God done brought us through so much. God done brought you through some things. Now you know, if it was up to the devil, you wouldn't be here, I wouldn't be here. The enemy would have killed us a long time ago. But you got to already know that the enemy can't take you out. God got a handle on him. Let me say it one more time. If it was up to the devil, you wouldn't be him. Now some of y'all know this for a fact. I'm gonna get from the word today. I'm already preaching, but I got a good scripture text where we come from there. Yeah. I said, and some of y'all, that's why you see some people praise God more than other people. Because some folk really know where they came from. I sure don't think I'm all that in no bag of chill. I know if it had not been for grace. Y'all to something, but I'm gonna praise her. I know God with me.
Oh, Jesus.
I know when I get to heaven, but I believe the devil, I believe it like he asked for Peter, said, God, if you let me have him, I sift him as wheat. I believe there were times in my life that the devil really wanted to sift me as wheat. But I'm glad that God had destiny over me. And what the devil meant for evil. Touch that neighbor and say, God had a plan for your life. Go ahead, tell him like you mean it. Say, God got a plan for your life. This ain't no coincidence, Hakeem. This ain't no incident, Carl. God got plans for our life.
Glory.
Marcus, this ain't no coincidence. God got plans for our lives.
Yes. Oh, glory. Yes. Thy will be done, Jesus.
This is the season where God now is telling you, hey, hey, sober up. Sober up. And I share with the ministers, I share with my secretary and clergy was back there, Sister London, and I'm sharing with them. It's a season now where God wants you to just spend time with Him.
Amen.
Stop trying to make things happen.
Amen.
God already done took you through some stuff.
Yeah.
You already done been through some things. You done been delivered from things.
Jesus.
And through and because of what you've been through, God said, I've given you wisdom.
Yeah. Hallelujah.
You ain't never stupid.
Glory to God.
Touch your neighbor. Say, I ain't never stupid. Ain't never stupid. I know you can look at some things and you can say, boy, that was it. You ain't stupid, but that was stupid. And because God done delivered us and brought us out. Now come here. God said, because I delivered you and I brought you through some things, God is saying that you see better than you ever saw before. Spiritually. Stop trying to live for God with your head in the sand. Get up and open your eyes. God says it's a season for soberness. And watch God bring the thing to pass. Some of you right here and right now, you're gonna walk into your destiny. You're gonna walk into the season that God had designed for you from the beginning. You're gonna operate in the season. This is the season that you're living in. So stop fighting. Watch your tongue. I'm giving you wisdom now. If you're going to operate in your season properly, you got to watch what you say with your tongue. Stop fighting that, people. Don't let your flesh cause your tongue to say things to knock you off course.
Amen.
Because your situation will get you so frustrated until it starts. Don't you know your tongue is your course? In a ship, a big old ship. You see them big ships out? And it's a little hymn that guide that ship.
Yeah.
As big as that ship is, a little hymn guide it.
Yeah.
Turns it wherever it wants to go. The big ship got to go.
Yeah,
the one man turning the ship.
Yeah.
Can I tell you, God is telling me this time of your season in your life that your tongue is your hymn.
That's right.
And it's going to turn your life. You got to start speaking what God said in your life. So therefore, you need a word from God. You can't sit around here and don't get a word from God. You can only speak what God tells you to speak. But if you don't hear God tell you, man, you don't know what to say. I was doing my devotion last night. When I was doing my devotion, God spoke this word to me. You got a lot of people. God said, you're going to walk by faith. And people don't understand that. Sometimes you say walking by faith. Faith is not presumptuous. Faith is not guessing. And God spoke to my heart just as clear. He said, tell my people, I want to walk by faith, but I want to walk by wisdom. You ain't shout off there. You're going to walk by faith, but you're going to walk by wisdom. And I wrote it down. I'm going to walk by faith, but I'm going to walk by wisdom. Because if I don't walk by wisdom, then I won't know how to operate in faith. A lot of people believe in God for some stuff, and God said you don't receive. Because you ain't walking in wisdom. He said you're asking because you're asking amiss to consume it on your own lust. So God said, now if you're going to walk by faith, you got to walk by wisdom. And right now, I'm just as happy.
Amen.
You know, it's good for you to know the season that you're living in.
Hallelujah.
When a man or woman can know the season they're living in, they ain't panicking. They ain't wavering. When you know the season you're living in, you're stable. Storms will come, but winds will blow. You stable. The same text that I was just mentioning for God said, know this one thing, that a man or woman that's wavering can't receive anything from the Lord.
That's right.
Jesus.
And wavering minded does not mean that things ain't gonna come across your mind at times. That don't mean I'm wavering minded because doubt try to stick his head up what I'm believing God for.
Yeah.
That don't mean that I'm wavering. You can't. You know a principle that we live by around here. Anyway, faith is not the absence of doubt. It's the overcoming of doubt. Tell your neighbor that. Preach to him. Do it. Follow somebody else. Tell them faith is not that. It's the overcoming of doubt. Now tell them, if you believe God, doubt will show up. But that's all right. Faith overcomes doubt. I dare you to turn around and say, I see some overcomers. I dare you to turn around and say, I see some overcomers. Come on, speak to the overcomers. Say, overcomer, overcome, overcome, overcome obstacles, overcome situation, overcome devil, overcome trials. Okay, now I'm finished. Sit down. But you gotta understand the season that you are living in. It's a season of soberness. Sober up.
Glory to God.
Sober up.
Amen.
I'm gonna come to church and jump, and I'm gonna shout, I'm gonna get high in the spirit, and then I'm gonna sober right back up. Cause I know the God that I serve is an awesome God. In my conclusion, I was at the hospital and I was about to leave, and the family stopped me and said, Bishop, you got to pray. I said, yeah, I got to pray. Yeah, I got to pray. So, Bishop, you got to pray. You know, I said, yeah, I got to pray. Yeah, I got to pray. We joined hands with the family. And I didn't get up there hollering. I want to make sure that I understood what I was saying. I wouldn't get up there in the name of Jesus. I already know in the name of Jesus I got authority. Yeah. Learn what to say.
Amen.
Don't only walk by faith, walk by wisdom.
Yes. Amen.
Yeah. Say it, Bishop.
Oh. I said, okay, God, I joined hands with the folk. And I said, okay, God, my brother going through a dilemma.
Yes.
I said, you told us to come boldly to the throne of grace.
Yes.
And we'll find help in the time of need. The family needs you now. Grace, come in the room. I was praying just like this. We were in the middle of the hospital waiting room, the big one, out in the front. I said, Grace, come in the room. People started praising God. Folk was walking by. Grace, come in the room. Ain't nobody got time for sitting out here and being discomforted. Ain't nobody got time to sit right here and worry with worry. The God that we're serving, he's well able. Y'all don't hear what I'm saying. I heard the doctor report. I was sitting there when the doctor came and talked to the wife. I heard what the doctor said. Don't expect him to get up too soon. This is going to be a long process. We don't even know if he's coming out. 75%, he might die on the table. We got to go. We got to hook some things up in his groin and run up through all of his other stuff. It got to come out the side of his neck. So we got to look in his mind to see what we can find. And I'm sitting there, I'm saying, oh my God, I didn't even know it was that bad. They can't find nothing. Say we're going to be, and then I got a text. I was coming back home last night. I got a text. Somebody texted me and said, hey, go ahead and rejoice. Minister Allen, he done gained consciousness. Now he's supposed to get up now. That's what y'all get. Get off the stage. Hey, this is a seat in your life where you just got to believe God. Come on, anybody here believe God? Touch your name and say, neighbor, I need to learn how to pray. I need to learn how to believe God for my situation, for my circumstance, for my dilemma. And tell them about three people and say, it's your season. Come on, tell them again, say, it's your season, it's your season. Come on, tell them, it's your season, it's your season. Ghost is seasoned. Tell us about it's a season. I know the devil talking smack, but it's your season. I know you've been going through some stuff, but it's your season. God is getting ready to do some stuff. Right in the midst of what you're going through, God is getting ready to do some things. It's your season. Throw that hand up towards heaven. Let's give our God some praise. We bless the name of the Lord in this place. Hallelujah, Jesus. You are worthy, Lord God. I'm about to take my seat. Let this moderator come up here. Get that hand up. Get that hand up. We ain't got time to be sitting like perpetrating, worrying about a devil, worrying about a situation. Come on. Let's get ready to enter into your season. No matter what the enemy done try to set up, you more than a conqueror. Bless the name of the Lord Jesus. With that hand elevated, take that altar, take my seat. It's a new season. It's a new day.